this is something that your mom would say to you, hey, baby. I say, my brother Ross, what Reverend Ross would say to his children, I travel path you yet to walk, learn lessons old and new. And now this wisdom of my life, I'm blessed to share with you. Let kindness spread like sunshine. Embrace those who are saved. Respect the dignity. Give them joy and leave them feeling glad. Forgive those who might hurt you and those who have your pride. Listen closely to your viewpoint. Try to see the other side. Walk softly when you're angry. Try not to take offense. Invoke your sense of humor. Love and power is immense. Express what you are feeling. Your belief is your uphold. Don't shy away from what's right. Don't shy away from what's right. Be courageous and be bold. Keep hope right in your pocket. It will guide you day by day. Take it out when it's needed. When it's near, you'll find a way. Remember friends and family of which you are a perfect part. Love deeply and love truly. Give freely from your heart. The world is far from perfect. There's conflict and there's strife. But you can make a difference by how you live your life. I'm so very blessed to know the one you would do because you are my children and I believe in you. So to Reverend Marshall, my brother, children, and dad love you. Now, he would say this, he was living, I love you now, I love you still. I always have and I always do. God bless you, be encouraged, and let nobody or nothing separate you from the love of God. Do what you know is right in the outside and God. Come on, what we do for Christ will last. Amen.
Yeah, I'm going to make this quick on Pearl that said exactly everything in that poem right there. First of all, my name is Tyree L. I'm the nephew. And my uncle, he was very versatile. It's like three parts of him. A lot of people didn't know. Just like the number one versatile was book smart. Well, number one versatile was probably family smart. The number two is book smart, and number three is that very athletic. So I'm gonna make this real quick because I want everyone to be happy, not sad.
Yes.
Because I'm just gonna tell you a little story. This one story, short story. It was with me and my cousin Royce Jr. over there, and then his brother Edwards was not here today, and. We had a game of basketball. What my uncle said, well, nephew, I heard he was good at basketball. That's all your dad talked about and all this stuff. So one day he challenged us in the game. And he said, well, don't be mad when I beat you in this game. Because I thought he was too old. You know, he couldn't take it over at that time because we were about 18, 19 years old. And so we all looking at each other like real crazy when this guy was just like doing all his thing on the court. And I'm like getting mad at man. It's like, what the heck is going on out here? So I had a little temper. So then my uncle said, he said he was going to beat us. He did. this last day, I went to go see him about 3 months ago. So every time he put it in my head, he said, remember that game? He always told me he loved me, too. He said, I love you, nephew, and stuff, because I want you to come and see me a lot more. We supposed to have a big dinner at my house, but he got real sick. He was hiding a lot of stuff from me and the family. He just didn't want everyone to know. He just told us he was very, very sick. So he was trying to get everything prepared, just everything prepared. So and that's how I look at it, so because when I talk with Ms. Errol Ray over here, I told him exactly what he told me, and so he told me just keep the family going, put the kids on the right track. No, no, no.
Oh, that's
okay.
All right. That's all right. We have to just